All right, good afternoon. Today I'm going to just walk you through the checkbook assignments. What I did was I saved the Unit 3 outline, and then I created kind of a dummy sheet. What I advise is that maybe you print out the entire outline and then kind of fill it in by hand, and then go back and type in your answers before you send it to me for the checkbook. Or you could try to do a little bit like what I'm doing here is I have kind of the directions right there. I'm going to open up the outline here, and then I'm going to fill in the register kind of as I go. But this would be hard to do once it comes to reconciling at the end of the month. But I'm going to kind of walk you through a little bit about how to kind of do this, and I'm going to walk you through a couple of examples. I just noticed I need to add a column here for check number, so let me do that. Insert, left. There we go. Just fix my little spreadsheet here, and I'm just going to put check there. Okay. So first one, received a bank loan for starting your business. So we're in January. We got the date. Today's the first. Since we're not writing a check, we leave that blank. This is a deposit. We open our checking account by depositing $15,000, and we're going to now have an ending balance of $15,000. The next transaction, we're writing a check here for, let's see, what's the check number? The check number is 101. So we're writing check in number 101. The transaction, you write down the payee. The payee is Partman Reynolds. And the check amount is a debit for $2,000. For an ending balance of $13,000. The next one, we are writing a check to State Farm, check number 102, State Farm. The check amount is $1,250. So you kind of get the point of what I'm doing here. Now, just remember, debits are anytime you have an ATM withdrawal, debit card, that's a debit, and then credits are when you add stuff to the account. So that would be deposits. If you have service charges, those would be in the debit column. If you've earned interest in the account, that would be in the credit column. So that's basically what I'm looking for you to do. I'm looking for you to read the transaction, put it in the register. Now for deposits, now deposits, we're going to have to fill out the deposit ticket, because if we look here at January 7th, I want you to actually go to the deposit ticket and actually fill it out. And the reason why this is important is that the only thing that goes into the deposit ticket is the net deposit amount. You don't need to list each part of the deposit separately. I'll just abbreviate here, January 7th, 2012. Okay, and we're gonna go up here and we're depositing that, we're looking at the 7th here, I kind of skipped ahead. We're depositing $100 cash. And the check amount is $452.34. Therefore, the total deposit is $552.34. Put that there. Now, less cash received. If I deposit checks and I want to take money out, maybe I want to put some cash in my pocket for the weekend, that's when you fill out less cash received. The deposit ticket will, the deposit transaction line will tell you that. This one doesn't have it, so we leave blank, and so therefore the net deposit amount is $552.34. Now we have to remember that when we do this, that the only thing that goes in the register, and I repeat, the only thing that goes in the register is the net deposit amount. So that $552.34 would be the credit of $552.34. And so when we get to that transaction, obviously, it would fall in the credit column. So that's how you fill out the deposit. That's what I'm looking for you to do. You keep this running balance after every transaction. You're going to have the balance. And then when you get to the end of the month, it tells you to reconcile your account. Do not move on until it reconciles. And so the reconciliation statement, you got to scroll down a little bit. Here's the reconciliation statement. So you're going to check off the entries on the statement, on the entry that match entries, check off entries and register match entries on the statement. I showed you this in a prior lesson how to do. So you just go through. There's the 15,000 right here. So X, the 2,000, there's the 2,000. Now, you notice the 1,250 of check 102 is not on there. Now remember, that's going to be a outstanding payment. So that 102 is going to go here. And obviously, I think there's another one in there too. So you do exactly what it tells you to do in the directions here. Basically, this ending balance here that you come up with should match the ending balance on the register. And if it doesn't match up, then you got to figure out what you did wrong. Here are some things that people do wrong. One, they put the debit in the credit column. They put a credit in the debit column. Two, they have math errors. Three, they have sliding errors. So instead of 1,250, people do this, I'm telling you, they'll punch in 125. Or another thing that they'll do is they might transpose a number. So they might type it in or write it down as 1,520. So that's why it's important when you go through and you check these numbers off that you really make sure that you wrote those numbers in correctly. Don't forget also to deduct any service charges, and that's what 3 says. So it's very straightforward. You're basically matching up what you say you have, what the bank says you have. Find out why there's a difference. What would cause those differences would be outstanding payments and then also deposits in transit. So that's some things I want you to keep in mind. So you got 3 months to do. I'm not making you write the checks. I'm going to make the assumption that you know how to write a check. If you don't know how to write a check, you know, your parents could show you how to do that. I could show you how to do that. But as far as time goes, this is kind of, instead of having you write 20, 30 checks out, I think you're going to thank me. You're just going to put those checks in the debit column in the register. It's important to keep track of your money, and you can't go on to invest in real estate. You can't go invest in the stock market. You can't buy insurance policies. You can't buy real estate. You can't go on to all those other things where really your net worth is going to go up when you can't manage your day-to-day finances. And the way Americans do that is through a checking account. There are people in this country that do not have checking accounts. Generally, low-income people don't have enough money to keep in a checking account. So when you go into low-income neighborhoods, that's why you see currency exchanges and stuff like that. They'll actually go in and cash your check, and at the currency exchange, they'll have them write their bills out for them there, pay a fee, and then walk away with whatever money is left over from the check. They just don't have enough money to keep in a checking account. But most Americans do have checking accounts. This is the way we keep track of money. If you assign a debit card will automatically withdraw the money out of the account. It's different from a credit card. A credit card, the bank is paying for that transaction, and then you owe the bank the money back by a certain date, interest-free. And once that day hits, whatever goes unpaid starts getting charged, a finance charge. That's more in the credit card lesson. Anyway, if you have any questions on how to do this, you know, feel free to ask. We could talk over the phone, email, whatever. Even if we have to meet in person, I would meet. But really, just look at the directions, read the transaction, put in the register, get to the end of the month, you fill out the reconciliation form. If your numbers match, you move on. If it doesn't, you got to find out what you did wrong. Once you move on, you got 3 total months to do this, and make sure you fill out all those deposit tickets wherever there's a deposit ticket, shown. Okay? All right. Happy reconciling.